respected dignitaries on the dais, respected teachers from various school, colleges, and other educational institutions from Kerala, ladies and gentlemen. I'm really grateful to the organizers of this SEACON for inviting me to share a few words with you. The education what we are imparting to our children in our country is actually due to the British people who came to India to rule. And the education of British and Europe that day was actually education after the French Revolution, when the whole Europe was transferring from cultivational economy to the industrial economy. One of the great European educationist and social scientist, Stanley Hall, he said, if you teach your children 3 R, the reading, writing, and the arithmetic. Though arithmetic starts by A, but in pronunciation, R dominates. Then your children will learn a 4th R. If you forget to teach them another R called religion, they will learn another R, the 4th R, which is called rascalism. He has criticized the educational philosophy of the modern Europe after the French Revolution. Since in the industrial economy, to propagate that, they have said the education as a means of acquiring some techniques through some training. And Stanley Hall has criticized that. And the Europe has gained all these things from the 300-400 BC, a big civilization, the civilization of the Greeks. And in the Greek civilization, the Socrates was at the top. His student, Plato, Aristotle, Alexander, in other way, Diogenes, Zeno, and other people. They are the great philosophers in the Greek civilization, and that was based on the city Athens. And in Athens, there were 3 lakhs people, and out of that, 1 lakh was slaves. So out of these 2 lakhs, 1 lakh was the ladies, the female, and in Greek civilization, the females were not in a position to take part in any progressive work. So it was hardly 1 lakh, and 50% of them definitely aged and children. So 50,000 people, they build up the whole civilization. They were the great people in the education, in the educational field. If 18 to 20 civilization came into existence in the world, the Greeks were in the high position. And Europe had copied the science, the philosophy of the Greeks, but according to Stanley Hall, without ethics and religious values. But if you look at the Christ, the peace be upon him, he came with the verses, with the revelations from Almighty, but he died early, at the age of probably 30 plus. So in the Christian civilization, education could not take a proper shape with the ethics, values of the Christianity. But you come later, in the 17th century, beloved Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he came with the, again, verses from Almighty, Iqra, and he started with that. And that verse indicates that if you want to be the transformer of the society, to become a leader, you must have the education, and that ikra indicates that shine, that in the future world, in this modern world, in the 17th century afterwards, if you would like to become a leader, you must have education. In the Islamic civilization, Prophet started with that Ashab-e-Suff first, you all know that. And he built up a brand of ambassador to spread the equality, fraternity of Islamic thought and values. And he succeeded. The people of Mecca and Medina, they have succeeded. They have formed a brand of ambassador, not only the Khulafa-i Rashidin, but with that, the 10 companions with great personalities of equality and justice to build up the just society, they have spread the message of humanity all over the world. We have that legacy. And I congratulate the people of Kerala. Your people, your forefather went to Mecca at the time to board that values of just society, equality, fraternity, and humanity. You have enlightened the whole India by brought that values from the Islamic civilization. So you have a great role to play. You have changed the values and ethics and the divided society of India to bring a just, valued society with equality and fraternity in our great country, India. I am very proud to be present in this hall, the Tagore Hall. Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore, once he said, the value of the education must be like that in Bengali, I quote, Chitto jeta bhoy shunno, uccho jeta shir. I translate it, where the mind is without fear and head is high held. Head is held high. That one of the purpose of the education must be your mind is without fear. You have to liberate your mind. That is what Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore said. So you are in a hall. It is probably a tribute to Gurudev Rabindranath Tagore. So now, in today's India, what we are seeing that a fear psyche is coming into the society. So you teachers have a great role to liberate the minds, to erase the fear from the young minds of this society, of this country. So the values and ethics of education must inculcate the equality, fraternity, and fearless, to have that fearless mind. Unless we have that, we cannot build up the just society. In Islamic values also, and in the Tagore's view of education also, we need to liberate the young minds so that they become a fearless mind, so that they build up a just society. Everybody has equal rights, everybody has equal values, and everyone respects others. In India also, from the ancient time, we have the educational values, but somehow the caste system and other, the divisions in the society, we could not build up the just society in our country. When Britishers came, they have propagated one kind of education which is definitely a copy of the education system after the French Revolution in Europe, which Stanley Hall, the great educationist, have criticized because it is the 3 R, reading, writing, and arithmetic, without the 4th R, the religion, and they have contributed or they have produced another R, which is called rascalism. And I hope the education in Kerala, it must be with the values of religion, ethics, and I'm not saying about a particular religions, but from other religions, you collect the good things and inculcate in the young mind so that our society become a just society. This is today in India, it is a challenge to build up a just society. I congratulate all of you in this conclave, the teachers. You brought these values, you try to inculcate in the young minds, then I hope our society will get changed. Our country will see a new kind of visions. I hope that by the grace of God, I end with these words. Assalamu alaikum.